You're kind of in this weird world where obviously you weren't in the team and you weren't on the bench either.
I went to the bar. And people get annoyed when they say, you went to the bar, you didn't support the team. No, I was went to the bar.
But you were at Wembley, did you go...
Well, I thought I was playing.
Right. And when did you find out you weren't?
That morning about, I don't know, what we were in that hotel up in Cockfosters in North London, the White Hotel, and we left there maybe, I don't know, we had a meeting maybe 11, 11.30 in the morning. You know, be round about.
Yeah, something like that.
Do you remember going into that room?
Yeah.
And Rudd got, like, the whiteboard up.
Right.
And just wrote the team. Right. Now, bear in mind, I played in the semi-final.
Mm-hmm.
I'd no inclination. I thought the absolute worst, I was going to be on the bench with Gianluca Vialli.
Yeah.
Because there was only two.
Yeah, this is a important
It wasn't
point.
Five substitutes. Yeah. It was two substitutes, and I think you were allowed a goalkeeper as well.
Right.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
However, you know, looking at this, the bottom line is, I thought I would be involved.
Yeah.
And when he wrote that up, and obviously he didn't tell me, and Rixey never told me or Eddie, any of them, and so there was just such a huge shock. And I tell you what, I'm okay about it now because it's like 20 years later, but at the time, and having somebody who held the FA Cup in such high regard, and we're playing Middlesbrough, and we have a better team than 94, when he wrote that team up, I can't tell you. Sat at the back of the room, in the meeting room or wherever it was like somebody had smashed me with a hammer.
I bet.
And I remember, Rudd said, right, that's the team, now we're leaving, here's the subs. And I was like, and I remember when the boys were all walking out, quite a few of them all come up to me and were like, because they kind of knew that was a bit unfair. I think it was a surprise to a few of the other guys.
Yeah.
Not necessarily that I was going to play, but that I wasn't involved at all. And, you know, it was hard. It was hard to watch the boys.
Yeah, watching it, did you want them to lose then?
No, I don't know. I don't remember. I don't think I wanted them to lose. But I just went in the bar at Wembley. I went on the pitch with the lads. Because you go out on the pitch before, hour and a half, hour and 45 before, you try and see the people coming in, the atmosphere, you get photos taken. I remember it from the 94 final.
Oh, but it's rubbing it in almost.
And Gary Richardson, I remember Gary Richardson coming up to me from BBC, who did a piece with me earlier in the week, and he came up to me and Mike in the face and say, how are you feeling? You're not involved. And then the other side of the coin was my family were up in the stand,
right,
or in the corporate area, and they'd no idea. And then it word filtered up, and I think my wife was very upset. So it's hard because these guys are having one of the greatest days.
Yeah.
And then what you think is going to be one of the greatest days becomes ultimately a disappointment because you don't feel part of it.
Sure.
It's understandable. It's completely understandable. You know, I felt that when I was with the national team, when I wasn't picked in the first 11.
So of course,
I was on the bench, but you don't play all the Euro 96. I didn't play one second.
Yeah.
And we reached the semi-final. And you see people being picked and coming in, and you're not there where I did all the qualifications as a central defender. And I understand his frustration, and I'm very sorry because, of course, when you are before the game, you don't really pay attention. You're concentrated towards yourself about what you have to achieve, and you forget about the friends. So I always thought about when he put everything down, when Rudd did that, every game he did, not only the final. You think about the players who are not involved, and you know the frustration.
Yeah.
We're all competitors. We're all football players who love to play. We just don't want to be just there. We want to be involved. We want to take risks. And I understand Craig, the frustration. I can even understand. I remember when we lost in semi-final in 96, everybody was very disappointed and because they didn't reach final. I say to my ex-wife, I remember saying, we're going back home.
Right. That's because it. You're relieved because you're just a bit
feel being useless.
Yeah.
And it's not your life. As a football player, you don't want to be useless. You want to serve the club or the national team. So I understand completely the spirit of the players who are not involved and they are at the bar. They don't care about us winning or not. It doesn't change their life. It doesn't bring anything to their life. So I understand the frustration. It's just normal.
And I didn't want to hang about the dressing room before the game because I didn't want them to see me moping around.
Sure.
Because they need to get in the zone. And I don't want to be going around the dressing room saying, can't believe I'm not playing.
Yeah.
You know, because, and I couldn't go around with a big smile because it was one of the most disappointing days in my life, footballing life back then. So I had to take myself out of it. It was interesting though, and people, Chelsea fans will still say stuff like, oh, well, you know, on social media, well, you're bitter because you're still bitter against Chelsea because they left you out. And the people have got to understand, and I said this about Celtic when I left, and people say you're bitter because the football clubs don't sell you and football clubs don't pick the teams.
Yeah.
Individuals who are employed by football clubs at that time make decisions. And then years later, those individuals are not there.
Yeah.
The football club is the football club. But what was disappointing to me, and to get the negative out of the way, because it was a great day, was that later on, Stevie Clark told me the reason I wasn't on the bench because Rudd was annoyed because I was turning down my new contract.
Right, so it was political.
It was a little bit political because they'd offered me a 4-year contract and the money wasn't good and I kept turning it down.
Right.
And Stevie Clark told me later, I don't know if true or not, if you'd signed the new contract, you would have been involved. And so ultimately I went to Celtic after that season and I made the transfer. But
You still got a medal, you still, I assume. Did you get FA Cup winner's medal?
You got it?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
Really?
I couldn't even tell you where my runner-up medal from the semi-final is.
Really?
I don't know. The whole day is... From the minute he put the name, from the minute Rudd named the team in the hotel, the rest of the day... I can remember the Di Matteo goal because it was special, but the rest of the day is a bit of a haze to
right.
me.
Right, okay.
It's not as... I can't remember that day as well. I would have remembered every detail had I played.
Yeah.
Now it's just like a... What was I doing that day?